And our second matchup of the day is going to be Wolf Glick versus Naoto Mizoguchi. And I'm so excited to show you a deeper look into Wolf's player profile.
I would never go into a tournament saying, I'm gonna win this tournament. You know, it's just, it's not really my style. And of course, we're playing against the best in the world, but I think I'm also one of the best in the world. And so I hope to make some other people sweat when they see that we're matched up. My name is Wolf Glick. I am from Washington, D.C., and I am the 2016 Pokemon VGC World Champion.
That's it! Wolf Glick is your new Players Cup 2 champion!
And Wolf Glick is your North American International Champion!
I started playing Pokemon competitively back in 2011, and I had always been playing Pokemon since I was very young. I loved the series, I loved watching the TV show, and I played the card game for a while. I've been playing Pokemon for 10 years at least at this point, which is quite a long time, and I'm the only player ever to have won every level of tournament, and my resume is really impressive, and yet I don't feel that I'm at my ceiling. I don't feel like I'm as good as I can get. For me, until I feel like I hit a ceiling, until like I feel like I can't get any better, I'm still going to be drawn to Pokemon. For me, the question of rivalry and who my biggest rival is, it's Ray Rizzo, the three-time world champion and who many believe is the greatest player of all time.
Unbelievable. Three-time Pokemon world champion.
Ray and I played twice. Once in 2011, once in 2012. Both times were in the world championship's top cut. You know, I was very young. I thought, this is great. This is my chance at redemption. Ray eliminated me last year. Now this is my chance to have my moment where I get to win the world championships. What a nice story. And Ray demolished me. It's a record that I don't know if I'll be able to ever change. The finals of the World Championships in 2016 was really, really nerve-wracking, I would say. Because on the one hand, I had this great opportunity for redemption. I'd made it to my second World Championship finals, I'd gotten second the last time, and now this time, maybe I'd be able to win and take home the title. But on the other hand, I also might have been the guy who lost two World Championship finals and got second place twice.
Wolfie Glick is your 2016 Pokemon video game World Champion!
When it all came down to it, it was a matchup that I had prepared for, and some things went according to plan, and sometimes I had to improvise a little bit, but I was able to win, and that feeling of realizing that I'd finally, after at the time 6 years trying, and finally won the World Championships was, I don't think I'll ever forget it. It's a real honor to be included in the 25th Anniversary Invitational. I love Pokemon, I grew up playing Pokemon, it's been a huge part of my life, and I truly don't believe I'd be the person I was today if not for Pokemon. So I feel very grateful to be part of, you know, an official tournament and an invitational at that to celebrate the 25th anniversary. I'm just excited to be here and I'm excited to play against some of the best players in the world.
What an exhilarating first game to kick things off. Santee with a dominant 2-0 victory against Arashomati. Moving on to the next match though, this is going to be a clash of titans. Naoto Mizoguchi against Wolfie Glick. And this is going to be wild. I was talking about it a little bit earlier, but this features the two world champions that won in a restricted format. Naoto, of course, in 2019, Wolfie in 2016. So let's quickly take a look at both players.
Yeah, let's go ahead and take a look at Wolf's accomplishments. Obviously, they have been able to win at every single level of competition. Players Cup 2 champion the most recently, and then you also are the North American International Champion in 2019, the World Champion, of course, in 2016, and a World's Finalist in 2012.
And of course, Naoto, the reigning world champion from 2019 with some other really impressive accomplishments. He got top four at Worlds in 2015, and this isn't even listed on his player card, but he actually got, I believe, ninth at Worlds in 2010. Both Naoto and Wolfie are two of the kind of older players in VGC. Both of these players have been playing VGC for over a decade at this point, and I think for Naoto, it's really interesting to see him, get ninth at Worlds all the way back in 2010 and then claw and, you know, finally get a World Championship victory in 2019. Wolfie really one of, if not the most decorated player in the history of the game. So I'm so excited because, these players really know their restricted Pokemon better than anyone else.
Yeah, oh my gosh, I'm so excited to see this matchup as well, especially because Wolf's team is so interesting, Aaron. The Groudon, the only Groudon in the entire Players' Cup 25th Anniversary Invitational, and that Cherim as well that I've got to mention has that ability Flower Gift. So the sun that Groudon is going to be able to set for the team actually increases the attack and special defense by itself and its allies by 1.5 times. So you're definitely going to be able to keep yourself really safe, especially when you take a look at some of the special attackers that are on Naoto's team.
Yeah, for sure. I mean, this is definitely a really fascinating matchup because I think Wolfie's team is one of the most creative teams in the tournament. Like you mentioned, you know, only Groudon. And I think Wolfie actually probably designed this team really against Zacian specifically. Like, I'm looking at the matchup here between him and Naoto, and like, it is so difficult for Zacian to do anything. You're going up against Entei, Incineroar, and Groudon. All three of those Pokemon are pretty tricky to go up against, to be honest. So Cherim, like you called out, also a really interesting option. I think realistically, Wolfie can bring any combination of Pokemon here. You might want to be a little bit careful about setting up Trick Room with Dusclops because Naoto, of course, does have that Amoongus. And so, yeah, I think like Wolfie can just go offensive, you know, bring the Groudon, bring the two fire types, and then one of the Zapdos or the Cherim. And from Naoto's perspective, like, this is going to be tricky because, to be honest, Zacian is not good here. And that's when your restricted Pokemon is not good into the matchup, it's like, okay, what do you really do? I think part of the problem here is that Naoto's damage, so much of it comes from the Zacian. So if Zacian isn't doing damage, well, what are the other options? Regieleki does nothing into Groudon. Amoongus doesn't do damage. Grimmsnarl doesn't do damage. So then it feels like you're really relying on Urshifu. So my eyes are on the Urshifu for Naoto. If it can, you know, put on some early pressure, then maybe you can have a Zacian sweep in the late game. Zacian is a Pokemon that could maybe Sword Dance as well. And so if Naoto has that, then maybe it's about positioning it properly. But this is definitely going to be a tricky one, I think, for Naoto going into this matchup.
Well, especially when that Urshifu on Naoto's side of the field is going to be that Urshifu Rapid Strike. It has access to those Surging Strikes to be able to deal those critical hits. But in that harsh sunlight, you know, it doesn't matter, right? So those crits are going to be able to do so much more damage, and it's going to make sure that that Urshifu can really shine. So it's definitely very critical to get that Urshifu into a proper position so it can really dish out that big damage into those Fire-type Pokemon that are on Wolf's side of the field. But enough talking about the match. Let's just get right into it, Aaron. I'm so excited to see this match play out.
I want Cherim.
Yeah, me too.
Let's see if we get Cherim.
I really want Cherim. But look at this. Naoto actually going to be leading with that Urshifu and Incineroar. And Wolf going straight away for that offense that you were mentioning is going to be bringing out that Groudon and that Entei as well. But in the face of that Incineroar, I feel like Naoto really is able to put on a ton of pressure just because, you know, that Groudon is going to be physical and that Entei as well.
Yeah, what makes the Entei so good here, though, is that it has inner focus, so it doesn't even get intimidated, and it can't be flinched by Fake Out, right? So it's like, even if Naoto just goes for a Surging Strikes into either Pokemon, it doesn't really do that much damage. I really love this lead by Wolfie because it just applies maximum pressure, and I'm not really sure Naoto had any option to cover for this, to be honest, right? It's like, you're not going to really want to lead Zacian, especially into, as we see, the Entei here's Choice Scarfed as well. So I think, yeah, Naoto makes sense leading the way he does. And, you know, the Incineroar can put on pressure with a Fake Out. You know, you feel pressured to go for the Fake Out just because even at minus one attack, Precipice Blade still does so much damage. But right now, Wolfie's Entei is just in a phenomenal position. And I like the Groudon switch out. Reset that Intimidate. Conserve it for the late game.
Yeah, especially when you can bring Zapdos out here in front of two Pokemon that really like to go for contact moves. Go for the Sacred Fire onto the Urshifu.
It's not super effective,
but does get the burn here. Wow, 50% chance of burning from Sacred Fire. So that is definitely going to help out a little bit with some of the other attack. But oh my gosh, look at the the Surging Strikes and Sun, Aaron.
It does like 11 damage per hit.
Yeah.
And this is part of the problem, right? I think like for Naoto, so much of his team relies on offense from Zacian, but Wolfie is like the perfect anti-Zacian team, right? Between the Entei, the Choice Scarf, or the Choice Scarf Entei, the Groudon, and the Incineroar. Even Zapdos, right? These are like probably four of the worst Pokemon that Zacian can go up against. And so even if Wolfie didn't get that Sacred Fireburn, I think he'd actually still be off to a really strong start in the battle. But by getting the burn, now it's even more difficult for Naoto to do damage, right? So you've got the Incineroar in the back, like maybe you can pivot out these Zacian somehow, you know, set it up. But, you know, when you're bringing Amoongus out right now against an Entei and a Zapdos, it does not look good, right? Like, right now, the Urshifu's damage output is just really lacking. You've still got this Entei getting these Choice Scarf, Sacred Fire, you know, in Sun. Wolfie still has the Incineroar and the Groudon on the back as well. And so, and there's the safety goggles on Zapdos, as you can see. So it's like, this is as hard of a like counter team as, you know, as it gets, it really feels like. And so, you know, even when the matchup is in your favor, you still have to execute properly. Wolfie led really, really well, made a really great play on turn one as well. And so, yeah, with that burn, I struggle to see how Naoto's going to do enough damage, but maybe it starts by getting putting some things to sleep with Spore.
Yeah, I think that Amoongus is going to have to be a little bit of an MVP for Naoto's team just to be able to help out a little bit with some of the pressure that is coming out from Wolf's team. Slow down the pace of the match a little bit with those spores, but actually going to go for a protect here just to make sure that it can stay a little bit safe, maybe expecting that something specific was going to come out from Wolf's team. And that Thunderbolt, though, just going to be able to knock out that Urshifu. And so, yeah, Zapdos already just going ahead and putting on a ton of pressure.
Yeah, this has really been a perfect game by Wolfie. I think like Naoto did have the small opportunity there to potentially go for Spore onto, you know, the Incineroar slot, but obviously that's so risky, right? He was staring down an Entei with Sacred Fire in Sun. So Wolfie has the matchup, he has the momentum, and he is making really strong predictions to give him even further advantages, right? Now it's actually really, really difficult. I think I could see what Naoto was going for. The idea was basically, hey, I need to get Zacian out safely next to Amoongus. And then the big question here is, does Zacian have something like Swords Dance? If it's Substitute, I just don't think he can do enough damage, right? But maybe if it's Swords Dance, you go for a Rage Powder, you set up that Swords Dance, you can pull something off. But because Wolfie has been playing so well as well, you know, now you get the Incineroar in safely, and just great positioning by him.
No, for sure. But did you see the Weather Ball reveal on the Zapdos?
Oh, I didn't even.
Oh my gosh. Oh, I don't think Naoto's going to be expecting this. That's not a move that we typically see on Zapdos here. And with the Sun, that is going to turn into a Fire-type attack. But there's the Inner Focus here. Not going to be able to lower that Entei's physical ability. But the Swords Dance now coming out from Naoto. Oh, that's so risky, Aaron.
Yeah, it feels like it's the only play he can go for. But like you called out, Rosemary, he's got the Weather Ball on the Zapdos. And the thing is, the safety goggles make such a big difference in this matchup, right? Like, Wolfie can make that play with 100% confidence, because even if Amoongus Rage Powders, well, you have the goggles, so you just ignore it. Now Wolfie, I mean, he has played this game flawlessly, right? You've got Entei out now. That puts on pressure with the Sacred Fire. And, you know, you can't get flinched by the Incineroar. Like, I don't think Wolfie could have played this game any better. But at the same time, I think Naoto's done everything in his power to keep himself in this match.
Absolutely.
It's just that Wolfie's basically been one step ahead of him. And it's, you know, so hard to win when your opponent has a, you know, advantageous team matchup and plays the way Wolfie is playing. But this is why Wolfie is the 2016 World Champion. But once again, like, I think for Naoto, there's just not much he can do in this matchup. And sometimes Pokemon is kind of a matchup-based game, right? And he's done everything in his power. With Wolfie playing as well as he is right now and the team matchup, it's just basically impossible to do anything right now.
Yeah, the Incineroar is going to be able to come out, and even though that we got to see the Swords Dance come out on Naoto's Zacian, that Intimidate is going to drop the attack from the boost that we saw from the Swords Dance as well as the Intrepid Sword, but Fake Out now, which was a great read by Wolfie just to be able to switch in that Incineroar, and now that Flare Blitz going right into the Zacian before it can even move. Holy cow, that Entei is putting in so much work when it comes to just being able to deal with all of that pressure that Zacian could have put out from offensively.
Yeah, and at this point, there's just no offense, right? You're down to Incineroar and Amoongus. Like, Wolfie has barely been taking any damage right now. You can see how strong of a pick this Choice Scarf Entei is. Really, all of Wolfie's Pokemon, like, each of them have demonstrated how good they are into Naoto's team, right? Obviously, the burn on turn one put Wolfie in a really commanding position to start the game. I think Naoto basically has to play really risky in this matchup because you can't get away with playing safe. So, like, going for a Spore with Amoongus at some point when you're worried about getting hit by something, right? Like, there was maybe a small opportunity in this game, the turn when Naoto protected the Amoongus. He could have maybe just went for the Spore. And Entei actually ended up switching out into Incineroar there, right? So if you put one of Wolfie's Pokemon asleep, at least you neutralize things a little bit, and suddenly, like, Wolfie can't just make all of these free switches and attack constantly. And yeah, it's been just, you know, as dominant of a game as possible. And so I think going into this next game, Naoto's one, I'm thinking, you know, maybe you bring the Grimmsnarl. If Grimmsnarl can set up some screens or has some disruption, that can be really valuable.
Right.
I think Amoongus basically has to go for some big, risky spores because otherwise, like, Wolfie is just going to out-pressure you. And, you know, even if he doesn't play perfectly, it is still already really difficult to win. And, you know, we saw that this wasn't even a close match because of how Wolfie played in this game specifically.
Yeah, the way that Wolfie played and also just the matchup in general, knowing that you do have so much pressure coming out from the fire type attacks that both of the Incineroar as well as the Entei can really dish out into the Zacian specifically. So that's definitely something that you got to look at and go, that's really tough to deal with. And sometimes even Groudon has that fire type attack as well. So a lot of pressure for that very, you know, centralized focus onto that Zacian on Naoto's team.
Yeah, and honestly, like, I think that going into this tournament, I bet that a lot of the players just didn't really have Groudon on their radar. I mean, obviously, mm-hmm. like, you know, Groudon's a decent restricted Pokemon, but it feels pretty weak relative to the main pool of Kyogre, Calyrex Shadow Rider, Xerneas, for example. And so, honestly, like, I'm guessing Naoto just in team building probably didn't think like Groudon would be a very big threat. And it's not just the Groudon on Wolfie's team. It's also like all the items are so strong here too. Like Choice Scarf makes such a big difference on Entei safety goggles, and the Weather Ball on Zapdos makes it even stronger, right? And so, yeah, I think that for game two for Naoto, it's going to be difficult, but yeah, you got to take some risks. Maybe go for some spores with the Amoongus on turns that you're expecting Wolfie to maybe make a switch. Grimmsnarl coming out can maybe set up the screens. And Zacian does have that Swords Dance, but even with the Swords Dance, it just still doesn't do enough damage, to be honest. But it's at least a start, right? Like, your damage, one, you need to avoid getting burnt from Urshifu. Two, you need to try to get Swords Dance off with Zacian. Three, maybe a couple spores off with the Amoongus. So let's see how Naoto adjusts.
Yeah, let's go ahead and jump right into the game once again. Go into that game number two, see how Naoto does decide to adjust their game plan here. And I agree with you. I kind of like to see the Grimmsnarl here just to be able to set up those screens. And that's exactly what we are going to see here. That Grimmsnarl going to be leading for Naoto as well as that Urshifu. But Wolf leading similar things to game number one with that Entei and that Groudon.
Yeah, I think, you know, Entei and Groudon is just such a consistent lead here. You have so many options. And I think what makes this really tricky for the Urshifu as well is that, like, even with Surging Strikes, which is super effective against three of the four mm-hmm. Pokemon, in the sun, it just really doesn't do very much damage, unfortunately. And yeah, I think for Naoto here, you know, part of the question I have is what kind of Grimmsnarl set is this, right? Like, do you have any interesting, like, shenanigans, whether it be, like, Eject Button? I mean, Eject Button is a lot less common in a format like this, obviously, because there's no more Dynamax. So my guess is it's probably dual screens, just classic, like, Light Clay. At least you can bulk up a little bit early on. And so, yeah, one thing I have to also wonder here is whether you're willing to risk getting burnt by Sacred Fire again. But I guess Naoto probably is like, you know, this is already a pretty tricky matchup. So I think I just have to take that 50-50 chance. But Wolfie doesn't even, you know, stay in with Entei, so no burn chance here.
Yeah, no burn chance. But we're going to see the Surging Streaks once again come out from Naoto's Urshifu. This time into the Zapdos. Oh, gosh. It's still not going to do a ton of damage here, especially in the sun.
Yeah, a little bit better. You know, last time I think it did like 35 or 40 damage total. So at least you're doing, you know, like double that. And with the Reflect, you know, Precipice Blaze doesn't do that much. But this Zapdos set is so tricky to deal with. As you can see, Wolfie was hovering the Roost and is considering going for it. Like, how do you beat the Zapdos in terms of damage if you can just heal back everything that you do, right? Like, Roost is such a big reveal here. And so, yeah, Naoto's got the screens up, but still, it's like, where is the damage coming from right now? It's certainly really not this Urshifu, especially when Zapdos is able to just heal it all the way back up.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, that Roost is so crucial, just to be able to keep that Zapdos healthy. And Surging Strikes, once again, going to be coming out from the Urshifu here. I definitely think that first... Oh, gosh. Oh, no. Groudon. Just taking it like a champ.
Three super effective critical hits there, and it doesn't even do 50%. And, you know, Roost is a smart decision there as well, because there is a small chance that Naoto maybe considers going for a, you know, Protect on the Urshifu. Mm-hmm. And so... it's always safe to just heal up there. Zapdos being as speedy as it is here, it's such a nice counter actually specifically into Urshifu. Zapdos is something that's seen, you know, resurgence in popularity, whether it be with safety goggles or something like a Rocky helmet, specifically to deal with Urshifu. Bruce makes it even trickier, right? So it's like Wolfie hasn't really taken that much damage. Now he has the Zapdos at full HP, can threaten with damage onto either Pokemon. Naota hasn't gotten his Sashian out, even when it does come out, just can't do very much. So even though the screens have gone up, it just really honestly feels like an impossible matchup.
Yeah, it definitely feels like Naoto's going to struggle a little bit here. Even the Aqua Jet going to barely be able to bring that Groudon to about half health. And the Thunderbolt, of course, going to be plenty to be able to pick up the knockout onto the Urshifu. And that's a ton of damage on Naoto's side of the field, just gone now. Spirit Break now coming out into the Zapdos here. So it's going to be able to do a decent amount of damage as well as decrease the special attack. But Static getting revealed here. That Grimmsnarl going to be paralyzed with a 30% chance.
Let's see if it matters. I think Heat Crash here will probably just finish it off.
Yeah, that's plenty.
that is a testament to Static though, right? Because it's a really good ability, and that's one of the other reasons why Zapdos is really nice as a kind of Urshifu answer, right? You can switch it in on a Surging Strikes and all those potential para chances from Static can really add up. So Naoto's down to his last two Pokemon. He actually didn't bring the Amoongus in the end, which, you know, makes sense. Once again, it's so tricky. You're going up against three Pokemon that can potentially just one-hit KO you with fire type attacks. And so does get Zacian in safely, does have the Incineroar next to it, so you can maybe go for like a fake out and then a sword stance here, or just go for damage. Once again, the tricky thing here is that Wolfie still has that Entei in the back. That can just come in and safely click Sacred Fire at any point, right? And with the Choice Scarf, it really makes all the difference. So one thing that's been interesting in these first two rounds that we've seen, Rosemary, is just the Choice Scarf. I feel it's like Choice Scarf has been such a huge item on the Kyogre in that first game,
for sure,
on the Entei in this game. I think at this point, Naoto, you need to go for fake out sword stance. It's just kind of determining who to target, but every single one of Wolfie's Pokemon has super effective damage into Zacian. Zacian's just not having a good time right now.
Yeah, poor Zacian. But you know, I think another thing about, and the paralysis again from the Static ability on that Zapdos. Yes, you can get the sword stance off here, but is it worth it? You know, Kent, is that going to be enough here? Because Groudon, of course, can just go for those Precipice Blades. Both of them are going to connect onto both Pokemon, and it's going to do a significant chunk of damage. But Aaron, something else that I feel like has been really influential in both the match one and match two, what we're watching right now, is not just the restricted Pokemon or the Choice Scarf, but the supportive Pokemon, the supporting actors that are at play here with each of these teams. They've just done a tremendous job of being able to support that restricted Pokemon, but also hold their own weight.
Absolutely, yeah. I mean, this Zapdos set has actually been really impressive. Between the safety goggles, that hard counter, the Amoongus, the Weather Ball, and the Roost, like, you know, the items just don't get any better for Wolfie in this specific matchup. Like, it couldn't have played out any better. So once again, I honestly think Naoto's done everything in his power to try to win the match. I think every play he's made has been good, right? It's just this turn does launch the Sacred Sword into that slot, actually. And so Groudon safely protected here. Like, if Naoto, you know, maybe he needs to make big reads here, basically. Unfortunately, he gets paralyzed with the Incineroar as well. So nothing going in his favor this turn. And that might just seal up the game, honestly, because at this point, you know, the Zacian can't heal itself, and there's just so many Pokemon super effective damage. There's still this Entei in the back, by the way, just waiting to come in and click Flare Blitz. And so, Wolfie willing to concede the Zapdos there potentially, right? Even if Naoto calls it correctly and you double up into the Zapdos, well, then you just bring the Entei and you just keep clicking Flare Blitz into the Zacian slot. Mm-hmm. So, yeah. Zacian is just unfortunately not very good into this matchup, and it's a testament to Wolfie's team building to build a team like counter Zacian this hard.
Especially when that was just a hard meta call, right? That maybe multiple players were going to be able to bring that Zacian as one of the top restricted Pokemon in the format right now. Unfortunately, the Incineroar is going to switch in and get knocked out on Wolf's side of the field, but it did get a little bit of that Intimidate drop onto both of the physical Pokemon on Naoto's side. But that Thunderbolt's not going to be enough. So we are going to see that Flare Blitz be able to fire back from Naoto. And that is going to be a double knockout here from Naoto.
Yeah, and you know, Wolfie is now set up his end game. You just get the Entei in with that Choice Scarf, outspeeds the Zacian, so you just click Flare Blitz into Zacian, Precipice Blades, and Naoto, like, the issue is, once again, there's no damage output into this Choice Scarf Entei, and there's nothing that outspeeds it either. So Wolfie willing to concede a bunch of Pokemon here, because at the end of the day, it's not about, you know, the number of Pokemon that you have at the end, it's just whether or not you win. And so he's pivoted himself really safely, right? Like, the one thing you don't want to do when you have this lead, if you're in Wolfie's position, is to just throw away the Entei. So all you need to basically do is say, okay, I'm going to give you a knockout, and if you get that KO, well, then I just get a free switch in, right? Mm-hmm. So all Wolfie had to do is make sure he didn't switch out that Zacian or switch in that Entei into a Zacian Sacred Sword, doesn't at any given point. And once again, the issue here is that Naoto's Incineroar just doesn't really do any damage. A lot of his team, unfortunately, just doesn't have great damage output because this team is so heavily built around Zacian. But Naoto really getting a tough draw here in the first round, running into probably the most anti-Zacian team I've seen.
Absolutely. Choice Scarf is going to allow that Entei to move very, very quickly to be able to go ahead and knock out that Zacian. And now you've got a single target Precipice Blades that can knock out the Incineroar. Wolf Glick also winning their winner's round one match in a 2-0.